Hello everybody! It's been quite a minute since I made a last video, so I apologize about that. And why am I wearing this mask, you may ask? It's pretty stylish, don't you think? Well, look at the dang Nisseimonji outside. It's like really bad. Like, normal? Okay, let me just tell ya. Is normally, like, the normal level is like an 80 or below. It's at 198 right now. That's bad. And then the Chomisemonji, which is like the really, really fine stuff that gets in your lungs and like kills you. The normal range is like 30 and below. And right now it's at 171. It is crazy. So everybody wears these masks outside. And oh my gosh, I hate it. I hate it. It looks like the whole world is like trying to like escape a zombie infection or something. Train to Busan, right? Heck yeah. So I had to wear that mask today. I didn't wear it in the morning because it's like it messes up my makeup so much. But gotta be healthy, right? So yeah, masks. That's always fun. Let's limit our pollution, guys, because we don't want the whole world to be wearing masks and, like, the world to be unlivable, you know? But, okay, so I'm making a Harry Potter camp now. Well, I already made it. Like, I spent, like, 3 weeks making this thing. And gosh, I'm so proud of it, and so that's why I want to give it to you. So if you're an English teacher and you want to do a Harry Potter camp and you want all of my materials, I will give it to you, give everything to you as a gift. So stay tuned to the end of the video so you can find out how you can get my Harry Potter materials, use them well, and leave a comment if you use it on, like, if you made any changes or anything you recommend and whatever. But anyway, I'll just tell you a little bit of the demographics for my school's English camp and how that all goes. This camp, there're kind of like two separate camps. Like, the lower level students, for the lower level students, my co-teacher taught a phonics and alphabet class, which it was really, like, I had to, like, listen in and kind of assist with that stuff. I didn't have to teach any of it. I just, like, listened in and helped the students, and I think that was really good for them. I really liked that. And then for my actual Harry Potter camp, there is an intermediate sort of level, like the normal skill level sort of thing, and there's, like, the advanced students. And with the normal skill level thing, with the intermediate students, normal level students, my co-teacher is in the classroom with me, and she, like, helps as usual. Like, I did all the planning, but she just helps with, like, any translations and stuff. Kind of like a normal class period, like, sort of situation. And then for the advanced students, it's only me. And the advanced students are really good at English. I wasn't sure, like, how well they would be able to understand me. But they're very, very good, so I'm very happy about that. And so yeah, I really like how this school, at least for this winter camp, it's organized by level instead of by grade, because it, like, learn at your level, you know? So I really, really like that. Each class can't exceed 15 students, so the lower level class that I did not plan, the lower level class had the full 15 students. The intermediate level class has the full 15 students. And the advanced level class must have been a little intimidating because it has only, I think it's like 8 students. Let me just tell you my feelings and, like, how I planned this stuff. I was so happy. I had, like, the whole week last week of school, I didn't have any classes. So I spent the whole last week of school all day planning for this English camp. And let me tell you, like, when I had, like, the full day to plan that whole week, like, I got through, like, a day and a half of English camp each day. So that was super sweet. That was really nice. I got through so much in that week. And then the last about week and a half, when I helped the other English teacher with her camp, I had about half a day to work on those days. I got through like half a day each of those days of English camp planning done. And so last Wednesday, I think it was, which was like the week before, like my English camp started today. Today is Monday. So last Wednesday is when I got my everything finished and like completed. I was so proud because, gosh, I spent so much time on it. So much time, and like I made everything. Like some like worksheets and like stuff like that, I got like some like inspiration online, or like I used like what other teachers had, because it's like, you know, it was a good idea, but I just like changed it and made sure that it fit my students and their level. And I'm just like so proud of how pretty I made everything. Sorry I keep saying that, but I don't know. I will tell you, today was the first day of English camp, so let me just tell you, I was so anxious because it's like so different from like the normal routine. And then especially the class I had to teach myself, and it's like, I don't know how well the students will understand, but today was perfect. Like, it couldn't have gone any better. Like, it was so great. The students were so great. And it's like, I know like the first day is like kind of simple, because it's like, I'm just like trying to test the waters.
Hiya boys, come on in, the water's fine.
So it was so cute. So like, I'll tell you what we did, because I'm so proud, because like, ideas. I can't believe I came up with them. But anyway, so first we did like the introduction, like welcome to the winter 2019 English winter camp. And like, each of the students got Hogwarts admission letters. We did a sorting hat ceremony. So like, I borrowed some witches' hats from a fellow English teacher, and we did a sorting hat ceremony. So like, on my PowerPoint I had like the student's name they knew to come up, and then they put the hat on their head, and the sorting hat would say things like, very difficult, and then like their house would just like pop up on the screen like, you're a Gryffindor, and like I was like super excited, and I was like, yeah, it was so cute. And so they got sorted into their houses, and their houses are going to be like their teams for the whole 2 weeks. And then we played a bingo game with like a ton of new like Harry Potter related vocabulary. Then we made like little neckties, and they could like color them to be like the house, their house. And then we ended with a like find the snitch maze. Yeah. First day today. Tomorrow we're making wands.
Wingardium Leviosa. Stop.
And it'll be great. I'm gonna take so many pictures and post them on my blog. I haven't been doing anything on my blog. Even like the one thing that I had been keeping up with, the K-pop thing, I haven't even been doing that. I feel so bad. Like,
I really am a failure.
I hope I still have readers. I don't know. But hopefully I will after this, because I'm going to be uploading a lot of new stuff, I hope. So yeah, thanks for listening to my Harry Potter English Camp, like how I'm making it part one. Oh yes, it's part one. Because I will give you kind of like an update on how everything went after it is completely finished. And after it's completely finished is also when I'm going to like upload links to all my materials on my blog, and hopefully you guys can put it to good use, because I mean, I'm very proud of it, you know, as if I haven't said that a million times. I mean, so anyway, yeah, thanks for watching this video. It's been a long minute, but hopefully I can put out another one soon in the next couple weeks when I finish. Spanish English camp. So, thank you. And I will see you next time. Goodbye.